We've discovered a tremendous amount of hydrocarbon resources, so we know we have a lot in the ground. But right now, we're trying to transition, or we are transitioning from development into our production phase. So the W1 well provides some real key information into that development planning.
Welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Max Easley. He is the CEO of Pantheon Resources. And Max, good to see you again.
Great to see you, Steve.
And also joining us is your Chief Development Officer, Erich Krumanocker. And Erich, it's good to see you as well.
Yeah, thanks for having us back, Steve.
Yeah, well, it's good to have you back because you've got some exciting news that you want to share with everyone. And Max, why don't we begin with you and talk a bit about the results today? Obviously, you're very happy with what you're seeing.
Yes, indeed, Steve. Yeah, as I always say, you know, measure Pantheon for doing the right activities and then getting good results. And this is certainly no exception to that. So as we earlier announced, we drilled a very long well here, almost 16,000 feet. And what we announced today was a large scale completion of that. I would say it's a fantastic but expected result. This is among the first of its kind, a completion of this scale in Alaska. But as you can imagine, we brought a lot of planning to bear here and a lot of expertise to bear here, given how important this well is. We brought in suppliers from Alaska, from Canada, the low 48. I think the real centerpiece of that, Steve, was a company we bought from Calgary, Element Technical Services. They actually pumped the job. I think everyone on North Slope took notice of the quality we brought to bear on that. We'll certainly work with them again. I think the most important thing here was throughout this entire large-scale operation, not a single injury or spill, which is the most important thing that we do. Now, the job itself, eye-popping numbers, we pumped 9 million pounds of sand, more than 9 million gallons of water. That's 32 million liters for those across the Atlantic. And we did this in 25 individual stages in less than 8 days. I've been on hundreds of jobs like this, Steve, in the Permian and the Montney. For a single well in a remote location, this is as good as it gets. So exceptional job. And just to put this into perspective for our investors, we're going to be releasing a video shortly to show the scale and quantum of what we achieved there and in the environment we're in. I think people will be impressed. So yeah, we're very happy with this, but Steve, now we're looking ahead.
Yeah, Erich, let's bring you into the conversation, talk a bit about the objectives of this particular well and really why it's so important to the company itself.
Yes, Steve, we've discovered a tremendous amount of hydrocarbon resources, so we know we have a lot in the ground, but right now we're trying to transition, or we are transitioning from development into our production phase. So the W1 well provides some real key information into that development planning. First of all, we'll get production rates for the well. This will confirm the commerciality, particularly of our oil and natural gas liquids for the field, for the Ahpun field. It'll also help define the facility designs. And the last piece, it'll prove our gas deliverability for the gas sales agreements we have. We also want to get more details on the composition of the fluids, particularly the oil, to be able to progress our access to the Trans-Alaska pipeline system. And the last piece, this will overall build confidence with our investors, potential strategic partners, and also support project financing.
Yeah, key important points for sure. Max, what's next at W1? Tell me a bit about what you have planned here. And obviously, Max sort of spelled out some key things that you have to do.
Everyone wants to see production, Steve. To get from here to there is a couple of things we need to do to the well. For a completion of this nature, long horizontal fractal stimulation, the first thing we have to do is every one of those 25 stages had a little plug in it. So we have to go in and drill those out. And we have a drilling rig still sitting on the pad. It needs to move over and run production tubing into the well so we can flow it to surface. Then we have to rig up some production equipment and then we'll initiate flow. That's going to be measured in a matter of weeks. Once we start this well, remember 9 million gallons of water have been injected already. You need to be patient because initially all that water that you pumped in, a lot of it will come back. So it won't be the very first day we'll have a headline result. It'll be through time we'll be communicating the market as we need to keep everyone informed. But we're really looking forward to this, Steve. This is the important part now. So we did all the technically challenging bits, and now it's time for the reservoir to talk.
Okay. Erich, one last thing I want to ask you about, something Max mentioned a bit earlier, just about the safety of the particular work that you're doing. It can be obviously a dangerous thing that you do, but the company continues to have safety at the forefront. Really, that's the people on the ground and your teams, I would imagine.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, most importantly, we have operated safely. We've done it in an environmentally responsible way. We haven't had spills. I just really like to thank the team, including our contractors and suppliers, for the tremendous execution, at a high level, basically beyond expectations in most cases on the W1 well. And we'll continue that high level of focus on quality, and we look forward to sharing a lot more good news in the coming weeks.
Well, gentlemen, it was very exciting to get this news out to everyone. Congratulations on it. Eric, good to see you again. Thanks for being here.
Thank you. Appreciate it, Steve.
And as always, Max, congratulations. Nice to see you again.
I see you again soon, Steve.
All right. There is Eric Krumanocker, the Chief Development Officer, and Max Easley, the CEO of Pantheon Resources.